Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our first time single take on his reaction to the Monkees and the song Pleasant Valley Sunday. It is a song from the year 1967, I'm sure you can read that too, along with me, and it's a request of our patron Jeffrey.
53 years old.
Down the street is trying hard to learn their song. Serenade, the weekend squire just came out to mow his lawn.
Another Pleasant Valley Sunday. Charcoal burning everywhere. Rows of houses that are all the same. She's proud today because her roses are in bloom. And Mr. Green, he's so serene, he's got a TV in every room. Another Pleasant Valley Sunday. Here in status symbol. Comfort goes, they only know my soul, and make it hard for me to see. My thoughts all seem to stray to places far away. I need a change of scenery. Another Pleasant Valley Sunday. Charcoal burning everywhere. Another Pleasant Valley Sunday. Here instead of symbol.
Two songs, one written and one performed.
This is so relevant even in 2020. You look around you, whether in Mumbai or in New York City, in LA, many other parts of America, many parts of India, many parts of the world, I would say, the big cities especially, or where the affluent ones live, those who celebrate their opulence and live in laps of luxury. Laps of luxury
makes more sense.
This says it all, doesn't it? 1967.
But long.
So relevant even today. Similar scenario today. You know, they, even though people have so much, they still complain about how little they have and how much more they need, and they don't have it yet. They don't realize the difference between needs, wants, and desires. What are your thoughts on this? I like the way it was sung, the music too.
I like the guitar playing throughout the song. I like the drums as well. It's a very good, crafted song, very well created song. And the lyrics are also thought-provoking as well as, you know, relevant into today's time as well. Charcoal is burning everywhere. It is a pleasant valley Sunday. People are happy at their happiest they could be. I assume this is a barbecue season. Summertime is the one, right? When people barbecue a lot in certain states of America. And people are doing their daily things. People need certain things to be happy. Mrs. Green is happy about her roses blooming. Mr. Green is very serene with so many televisions in his house. How can you actually be serene with so many televisions in your home? Every room has television. And mothers complain about how hard the life is. But when you look at it as an outsider, an alien drops there in the middle of the valley, he will really see people are happy, people have abundance of things with them. They are blessed. They have everything that they need.
Status symbol land.
It's a status symbol land.
How well it goes.
Yeah.
How well it is worded. You're in status symbol land. One of the best lines to put in there into a song like this.
Yeah. Just asserted.
Sometimes, yeah, many of us need to understand how lucky we are to be blessed with so much. Just the fact that we are alive and we don't have any health problems, severe financial problems, or any other problems really, is itself a reason to celebrate and to be grateful to God, or grateful in general, even if you don't believe in God. But yet we always want more. We are never happy. Our greed never stops. We are jealous, we are greedy, and we are hence full of hatred at the end of the day. And we, instead of possessing luxuries, objects or assets, we are possessed by them. I like this song. It's definitely a very, it's a song way ahead of its time.
Yeah.
Considering it came out in 1967.
Everybody was always busy talking about the war, the Vietnam War,
a lot of things, but I think
a lot of songs were heavily dominated
in
by
that
topic and the grief of the men and the middle class. This is one of those songs that is actually highlighting the other side of the society as well.
That you must be specific that it's only in America and
it's American song
where people used to talk about the war and this and that.
Considering the music that
the
came
world,
out around 65 and all,
most of the other parts of the world didn't
had different
really,
things to deal with.
Different other things.
A
to
lot
talk
of
about,
things to deal with. Yeah.
Think about.
India was dealing with outpour in the population. The population was bulging out at that time, right after independence, that drastic measures were being taken to, you know, stop it and slow down the population increase that was happening at that time. Different countries probably were dealing with a lot of different things. Yeah. And this was a pleasant valley Sunday where people were doing their own things and some people complaining, some people being overjoyed as life.
For me, it just makes me sick to think of all these people who, you know, are never happy with what they already have. Makes me sick. Really makes me sick to be around them, to hear about them. I'm very, very grateful. And most of people I know, you know, my family members, friends, most of them are very grateful. Maybe it's part of our culture in Asia. Most Asian countries, but I don't know, most of us seem to be very grateful about all that we have. But when I see people, my clients, certain students from the other side of the world, they're so unhappy. They're never happy with what they have. They have so much. Most of them have more than me.
A lot.
Very honestly, I can say they have more than me. If you talk about assets and status symbols, they all have more than me. But yet, I don't see the happiness. They're always looking for more. They're always greedy. They're always jealous, they're so possessive, they're filled with hatred. You know, essentially they're filled with hatred about so many things. So it sickens, it makes me sick.
It takes a trip to a place, a country where, you know, you see the contrast in the society.
And just like the songwriter Carole King and Gary Goffin and the Monkees, even I want a change in scenery. And thankfully, I'm in a part of the world where I don't need to worry about a change of scenery because I'm so happy where I am. I don't think there'll be too many people in the world who are so happy where they are as I am. Wow. That's it for this one. We'll be back with few requests for our patron Jono and Kai. You have James, you have Aha, you have Modern Architect of Aha separately. You have Sigrid, one of the best female voices of this generation in my humble opinion. You have Stratovarius, you have Saxon, you have Faith's Warning, you have Watchtower. And then our patron Kristen, the only patron that I know
who remembered
Women's Month, Women's Week, Women's Day, and requested all female artists which are female artists. We have Stevie Nicks, we have Berlin, we have the Go-Go's. Then we have Mary J. Blige, requested by George. Mary J. Blige, I used to like listening to her when I was in college. Wonder what happened to her, by the way. So we're going to listen to a song of hers. I may have heard it probably. Lot of things coming up, and of course, Ray Charles, the legend, Ray Charles. We also have Paul McCartney once again, a little very late in the session, maybe tomorrow, early morning, we'll be recording it. We also have Little Rimmer Band, Blood, Sweat and Tears, and then Merciful Fate.
Yeah.
Wow, King Diamond in the house once more. So a lot coming up. We've already reacted to Bill Whalen. What a beautiful song that was. An instrumental.
Music.
Irish instrumental. And then Oregon with their song Water Wheel. Another instrumental piece with the tabla, particular kind of flute dominating. Lots coming your way. Make sure you don't miss them. Music must be celebrated. And especially music from different parts of the world, different genres, if not different parts, different genres. And that's what we pride ourselves on. We listen to music from almost anywhere, any genre, any artist, though we always give an honest review. What we think, we share. And that's really rare, isn't it?
It's really rare. Thank you for watching.